Hello everyone, Alex here from warnoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can use embeds inside of Discord.js. So to get started, I have a very basic project here. You can go ahead and copy this code down, or you can clone from the GitHub repository found in the video description. I suggest doing that because we're going to be using this basic command handler I have here. Obviously you can pause the video and write this down, but it's much easier just to clone it from the repository. So the first thing we're going to do inside of our main files, we're going to import that command handler. So constant command equals require, and then command. And then we're going to create a new command. And the syntax for this is we're going to need to pass in the client. We want to pass in the actual command. In this case, it'll be embed. And then we have a callback, which will have a single message parameter. Now inside here is whenever we run the command exclamation point embed. And at this point, we want to create a embed and actually send that to the channel. So we're going to start things off by saying constant embed equals new discord.messageEmbed. And then we're going to chain some functions. We're going to say set title as example text embed. And then we can say message.channel.sendEmbed. We're going to add more to this, of course, but we're going to start off with just this. If we save it and we go into our console and we run node index.js, we can go into Discord. We see our tutorial is online and our client is ready. If we run exclamation point embed, we then see this right here, which is very basic. We're going to add more to it. However, it shows that it's somewhat working. So we can delete these two. If we go back, I'm then going to put this onto its own line again. We're going to set a URL, and this will be the Warnoff Keys YouTube channel link. We're also going to set an author. We're going to use message.author.username. We can see this if we console log message.author. So if we save this and we run our bot, going back to Discord, if we run exclamation point embed, we see our name here, which is my display name. And in the console, we see this user object. So we have a few different pieces of information. We have the ID, we have if they're a bot, we have a username, and we have an avatar hash and a few other things here. However, we just want the username. So that's how I knew that that was there, because I was able to console log that. We can also embed certain images into here. So I'm going to create a constant called logo, and this can be the Warnoff Keys logo. So I'm going to say set image. We're going to pass in the logo. Set thumbnail. I'm going to pass in the logo. We could save this and we restart the bot. We can go back and run exclamation point embed. And we see the logo as the thumbnail and the image. Obviously, you can enter your own images. Another thing we can do that includes the image is we can set a footer. This is a footer, and we can pass in a logo. The logo is optional here. I'll show you what it would look like without the logo, but if we run exclamation point embed, we see down here, this is a footer, and without the logo, it would simply just be the text. So if we go back and we run exclamation point embed, it says this is a footer. We can also set a color, so dot set color. #00AAFF. You can enter whatever hex value you want though, exclamation point embed, and we see that the text on the left, or not the text, but the bar on the left is now a different color. Now, one of the more popular features with embeds is to actually add fields. So we can do that with add fields. Make sure there's an S on there, and we can pass in any number of objects inside. So each object will have a name. We can just say this as field one, and then the value, which will be hello world. If we save this and we restart our bot, going back, we can run exclamation point embed and we see field one is hello world. We can add inline is true, which means that there's going to be multiple fields next to each other. And if we add a couple more, we can save field two and field three. We can save this and restart the bot. And if we run exclamation point embed, we see field one, field two, and field three are next to each other. If we then add more, like let's say field four, obviously you'd add your own text here, and then the value is hello world. If we save this, this one should be on the next line because inline by default is false. So if we run exclamation point embed, we then see field four is on the next line here. So these are all the basics of how you would use embeds inside of Discord.js. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.